Yo!
What's up? I'm Adam.
And I'm Patrick.
And in this video, we are going to look at what Azure Synapse Analytics is and why you should care about it.
Stay tuned.
If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both of these guys. All right, Patrick. Azure Synapse Analytics is one of the data platforms that Microsoft provides. This is like the old data warehousing kind of. What actually is Azure Synapse Analytics?
It's just SQL Server. It just works. I kid. It's not just SQL. It's so many things. It can be used as a data warehouse solution. It could be used as a big data solution. It could be used for data integration. You can even explore log and time series data using this thing called Azure Data Explorer. It's pretty amazing.
Wow, that sounds bananas, Patrick. That sounds like there's a lot of stuff there too. What does that even look like?
Believe it or not, Adam, that's just a few things. So imagine you have all these disparate data systems that you need to pull data from. At the bottom of this architecture sits a lakehouse. I like to call it a data lake, but the kids call it a lakehouse.
That's the new
term. So you can ingest all this data into the lakehouse. All right, so now all my data is there. Now, if you think about old school guys like me, and my Twitter handle is PatrickDBA for a reason. I used to be a DBA. Once I get the data, I'm gonna naturally put it in the SQL Server. But with Azure Synapse Analytics, you could choose. Are you gonna go SQL? Are you gonna use Spark? Or are you gonna use this Data Explorer? It's kind of like the best tool to solve the problem.
Awesome. So I think a lot of people, what they're thinking about is, okay, I get that it's out there, but why wouldn't I just use a regular SQL Server? Or why wouldn't I use some other relational database that's out of there to meet my needs for my reports?
Let's think about SQL Server. And I'm not picking on SQL Server because my career is built on SQL Server. So not picking on it. It's a phenomenal piece of software. But the challenge is it's just the SQL Server. And some people will argue, like Patrick, oh, you haven't played with like SQL Server 2019. You hadn't done a whole bunch. But I mean, it is not one-stop shop. And that's what you get with Azure Synapse Analytics. You can do data integration, you can do orchestration, you can do monitoring, you can do security, you can do everything in one single place using this thing called Azure Synapse Studio.
And that's really the first reason why you should care, right? Is everything's just in one spot, right? It brings all of it together. I know one of the struggles when using these technologies before is you had to wire all that stuff up, right? And you had to know how to like connect these things. So maybe I'm doing some Azure Data Factory, and then maybe I've got even some Databricks in front of that for some more transformations. And then I'm going to bring it into SQL Server. Like I didn't know how to do all those steps, and it was challenging.
With Synapse Studio, it's all just right at your fingertips. You know what you got to do? The thing that I'm learning with this is you got to learn the clicks.
You got to learn the clicks, Adam.
All right. That's the first reason. The next reason is you're not locked in. Again, I'm SQL Server. That's what I do. You know, I know SQL, but there's so many people in your organization. And when you start doing analytics, you'll come up with different needs and it'll be like, do I need to use a SQL? Do I need to use some other language? So you're not locked into just one thing, Adam. You can do so many other things.
If you know Spark and you want to go that way, then go do that. Or if you want to use like SQL or Azure Data Explorer, those are all options that are available for you. So you're not locked in to this one thing.
There's a third reason, and you and I talked about this, and you articulated this in a way that I thought was interesting. What's the third reason?
So my biggest thing is, look, you're on the Microsoft stack. And so when you think about this integration of the different Lego pieces that come together to build, you know, my Star Destroyer that's right there. And we bring all of it together, right, with the Legos, and they just build on each other. And so you're in that Microsoft ecosystem. So when we think about things like security and governance and administration, all of those are in one spot and they can go with each other. And so there's this idea of using things like Azure Synapse Analytics with Power BI. And I want to take advantage of things like Microsoft Information Protection Labels, where I can set that on the data source and that flows through to Power BI. And then if you do that export to Excel, which everyone loves, that MIP label is still going to flow through to that Excel document. And we look at other things like Gartner and Forrester, where, you know, the Magic Quadrant leaders in these spots, Microsoft has been a proven leader in all of those areas for a very long time. And so those are all things that come to bear when you're making your decision about a platform. All of these will come together from those Legos. They stack up, right? From your lakehouse into your data layer, into your reporting and analytics solutions, and then beyond. And when we start thinking about machine learning and all of these things that come together, bringing the power of Azure and Microsoft 365, all of these things together in one spot is just a powerhouse.
mind blown. It's amazing. It's amazing. It's bananas. I love it.
All right. We want to hand this over to you. Patrick and I are going to be continuing to explore Azure Synapse Analytics and just data in general as it relates to Power BI and the Microsoft ecosystem. And so we want to know from you, what else do you want to know about this? What have you been thinking about with Azure Synapse Analytics that you want to know more? Let us know in the comments below because we want to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button, smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from myself and Patrick, thank you for watching, keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.